The writer Stefan Zweig wrote a compelling account of the settings and emotions Handel felt as he stood at the threshold of composing the world's greatest oratorio of Jesus Christ, Messiah. Weathering the tempests of his career, he had been immersed in composing many forms of classical music, oratorio, opera, and music for the organ. One day, a letter lay on top of his desk from the poet Charles Jennens, who wrote to say that he hoped the great genius of music would look graciously on his poor words and carry them up on his wings through the ether of immortality. Handel misinterpreted the letter from Jennens, fearing that he was mocking him. Not even daring to read the poem, the envelope lay on his desk, untouched. Determined to push it from his mind, he retired for the evening. But he could not sleep. Handel rose, went back into his study, and once again lit the candle. Messiah read the first page. He turned over the title leaf and began to read. At the first words, he started up. Comfort ye, began the libretto. It was like magic, that phrase. No, not a phrase. It was an answer divinely given. The cry of an angel calling from the overcast skies to his heart. Handel heard the phrase as music, as hovering, calling, rushing, singing notes. His hand shook as he turned page after page. Yes, he had been called, summoned. Every word entered into him with irresistible force. All his weariness was gone. Never before had he felt his power so strongly. Never before known the joy of creation streaming through him like this. Again and again, the words poured over him like warm, redeeming light. And suddenly, he shivered. For there, in the hand of poor Jennens, he read, the Lord gave the word. He held his breath. Here was the truth. The Lord had given him the word. And behold, there the word was written. There it rang out, a word that could be repeated and transformed forever. Alleluia. 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 Tears blurred Handel's eyes, so mighty was the fervor in him. Hastily he picked up his pen and began setting down the notes. He could not stop. It carried him away like a ship with all sails spread, running before a stormy wind. Handel sat enveloped in a different world, consumed with composing the music that he heard. No one ventured to approach him. He did not leave the study for 3 weeks. Handel knew nothing of the hour in those weeks. He lived entirely in the sphere that measures time only by musical beat and rhythm. He moved only with the current that surged from him as the last work flowed closer to the sacred rapids of its conclusion. At last, on 14 September, the work was finished. What before had only been dry, sheer language now blossomed and sang, never to fade. Handel rose to his feet with difficulty. The pen dropped from his hand. The strength had gone out of him. His body was tired, his mind confused. He fell on his bed and slept like the dead. After 17 hours of undisturbed sleep, Handel began to regain his strength.
that her iniquity is pardoned. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. shall the eyes of the blind be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then shall that lame man leap as a hart, and the tongue of the dumb shall sing.
Oh. much for coming and enjoying this performance and the spirit that it brought to your season. Hope you enjoyed your evening. Please partake of the refreshments and converse with the performers. Thank you.